in between Spanish flavor. Never. I'm pretty sure some of you guys, you know, the PDA, yeah, and you hear me come up and they're like, yeah, 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 this guy's gonna be great. He's French, yeah, yeah, I've been to Montreal. These guys are hilarious, yeah, yeah, good people. When I come up, yeah, he's coming up. I don't get it. That's more like a Pedro to me. You know what it is? Everybody thinks, all right, my name's Pierre, so I have to be French. I have to. Your first name doesn't matter really what you are. I mean, traditionally, yes, but it's your last name. So people are like, oh, you have to be French. You have to be. I'm like, all right, let me put it this way, all right? Puerto Rican family. We have Davids in our family. David. None of them went to Hebrew school. Not one. We did not have one bar mitzvah. Okay, let me be fair on this. There was a chair thrown in the air, but that was because of a fight. You know how, like, Hispanic child parties, you know? Yeah, you guys were invited to one? Did you make it out alive? Of course you did. You ain't good, though, right? You know how to dance? That's okay, I don't want to dance. So yeah, you know. It's weird. What about this? How about this, guys? Do you guys hate that your phone auto-corrects what you're about to say? You hate that? Especially the bad words. Because when you text a bad word, and you mean it. You mean it. You don't have time to, like, you know. It's like, is it your phone going, no, here's a healthier solution. Use yourself a thousand words. You know, enjoy that. It's like I go to order a cheeseburger, a bacon cheeseburger, and the phone's like, yeah, have an apple. You're a fucking Samsung. What are you talking about? A little bit today. Yeah, you know what it is? It's crazy. Because my phone, I try to write fuck, duck, shit, shook, cunt. Let's be right, cunt. It does. Let's be right, cunt. I don't know why. My phone, right? Let's be right, cunt. My phone's like, yeah, it kind of like knows me. It's like, yeah, she's a cunt, fucker. Yeah, yeah, right. Keep writing. Yeah. So, I'm 29 years old. Clap it up. Why did you clap that? Thank you. 29 years old. I'm not married. I have no kids. Okay. Because I love your reaction. Are you married? Oh my god, this joke's gonna work out perfect. Okay. Oh shit. He didn't come with me, by the way. We look related, but he didn't come with me. Holy crap. Okay. It's working out better. Not married. Women, when they hear that, they think, why aren't you married yet? What's married? What's going on? You know, you're good looking, you're funny, you're Latin. What's going on? Why aren't you married yet? What's the problem? Well, everything, apparently. You kind of like narrowed it down. But it's a guy. It's married men who are the ones who kind of build my confidence when it comes to that. They make me feel less like shit. Married guy comes up and, hey, married? No. High five! This guy knows how to live! Aisle 4! The guy in aisle 4 stocking the shelves! He knows how to live. I like it. That guy. You know, we'll see what happens after the sex. I'm single. I mean, I just ruined my chances by adding that. So I belong to this gym. I belong to this gym, and there's this renovation that was going on. And this gym is, how do I put it? It's a suburban-y twice. And I don't exactly know if I belong there, but a couple years ago, they were doing like this multi-million dollar renovation, right? So there was like drywall broken down, there was like tarp everywhere, but they let, you know, it was nice of them, they let the, you know, the people come out and work out. Very nice of them, fucking unsafe as shit, but nice of them. So I go there, and I don't exactly blend in. So I go in there one day while they're doing the renovation, and I walk in, and one of the person, you know, they look at me, nothing. Even one of the workers is like, hey, fucker, did you make grab a hammer? I'm like, whoa, dude, I don't fucking work for you, okay? Why don't you guys get paid? I'm like, fucker, give me a hammer! So I go, I'm on the machine, right? I'm on the lifting machine. And I see this, like, this bubbly cute little girl with a ponytail, and she's like this, going like this. I got my headphones on, I don't know what she's saying. It's going like this. And then I take my headphone out, and I can hear her, and she says the word finished. So I'm like, okay, she's finished. She's talking about my set. So I look, I'm like, oh, 10 minutes. Put the headphone back on. And then she goes, Dara, did you hear that? They said they were going to be done with all of this in 10 minutes. Like, they work fast. And then Prince Aaron comes, like, you only said that because you want to blow him. I was like, what? But then Sarah had to fuck it up. She goes, either that or you're looking for somebody to support your 5 kids. I went right back. I fell into the stereotype. Like, yeah, you need the hey. What do you think? So, yeah. That's my time, guys. Thank you so much. You've been a great audience. Thank you so much. Thank you.